Good afternoon. Welcome to St. Joseph's as we celebrate this, the 12th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Today we also rejoice with the Universal Church, our great Diocese of La Crosse, with the ordination of Father David Nowicki a few hours ago. Let us rise and lend our voice in joyful song as we sing together hymn 134 in our spirit and song hymnal, Rain Down, hymn 134. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. And with your spirit. Brothers and sisters, let us call to mind our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Thank you.
grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name. For you never deprive of your guidance those you set firm on the foundation of your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Let us be seated for the readings.
A reading from the book of Job. The Lord addressed Job out of the storm and said, "Who shut within doors the sea when it burst forth from the womb? When I made the clouds its garment and thick darkness its swaddling bands? When I set limits for it and fastened the bar of its door and said, 'Thus far shall you come, but no farther, and here shall your proud waves be stilled.'" The word of the Lord. Give thanks to the Lord, his love is everlasting. They who sailed the sea in ships, trading on the deep waters, these saw the works of the Lord and his wonders in the abyss.
Give thanks to the Lord.
His command raised up a storm wind, which tossed its waves on high. They mounted up to heaven. They sank to the depths. Their hearts melted away in their plight.
Give thanks.
They cried to the Lord in their distress. From their straits, he rescued them. He hushed the storm to a gentle breeze, and the billows of the sea were stilled.
Give thanks to the Lord.
They rejoiced that they were calmed, and he brought them to their desired haven. Let them give thanks to the Lord for his kindness and his wondrous deeds to the children of men. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the love of Christ impels us. Once we have come to the conviction that one died for all, therefore all have died. He indeed died for all, so that those who live might no longer live for themselves, but for him who for their sake died and was raised. Consequently, from now on, we regard no one according to the flesh. Even if we once knew Christ according to the flesh, yet now we know him as so no longer. So whoever is in Christ is a new creation. The old things have passed away. Behold, new things have come. The word of the Lord.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On that day, as evening drew on, Jesus said to his disciples, "Let us cross to the other side." Leaving the crowd, they took Jesus with them in the boat, just as he was. And other boats were with him. A violent squall came up, and waves were breaking over the boat, so that it was already filling up. Jesus was in the stern, asleep on a cushion. They woke him and said to him, "Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?" He woke up, rebuked the wind, and said to the sea, "Quiet, be still." The wind ceased, and there was great calm. Then he asked them, "Why are you terrified? Do you not yet have faith?" They were filled with great awe and said to one another, "Who then is this whom even wind and sea obey?" The Gospel of the Lord. Good evening. How wonderful for us to be together today. These past few days have been just filled with so many gifts and blessings. I know many of you knew I was away in La Crosse since noon on Thursday, all the way up to about an hour ago. I've been either driving to or coming back from La Crosse. It's been a wonderful series of days, our annual summer gathering called Priest Unity Days. And it's a time where we come together, all the priests of the diocese. We have a series of presentations and prayer times. We honor those who are celebrating significant anniversaries. And of course, we pray for all the priests that died in the past year. This year, for the first time since I've been a priest, the number was zero. So that was kind of a neat thing. One of the other great blessings we had was, of course, Bishop Battersby and his presentation. Now, I love Bishop Callahan. Good and holy man, he ordained me. I'm so thankful for his many years of ministry to our diocese. But just to give you an idea of differences of folks and how they approach things and what they do, when we had Priest Unity Days before, Bishop Callahan was always on the last day and kind of the last address. And I'll be honest, one year he read his mail to us. That was our pep talk. It was pretty exhilarating, let me tell you, you know. It was always nice to get an update from the bishop. Don't get me wrong. Bishop Battersby was first on the docket this time. He wanted to set the tone. He wanted to set the vision. He wanted to say where these next few days were going to go. And his direction is mission. It was so renewing to hear Bishop speak so impassioned about being a missionary here in Wisconsin. To be able to recognize the good news that we have in our heart and the necessary response to Jesus Christ to do what he says, to go and make disciples of all nations. I think we are blessed, my dear friends, with a good and holy bishop who is so on fire for Jesus, and he wants to set us on fire too. This is going to be amazing. This is going to be a blessing. This, my dear friends, I think is going to leave a mark on the diocese that we've never seen before. And that's a good and holy mark. Now, our gospel reading today is, I think, kind of fits in it so beautifully. Now, imagine Jesus, sure, Son of God, he's worked a few miracles, but we're still kind of early on in, you know, the ministry of Jesus. He's a trained carpenter, and he gets in a boat with a whole bunch of fishermen, and they're not just like, you know, they go fishing on vacation, fishermen, like that is their living. And not only that, these fishermen have made their living on the Sea of Galilee. They know these waters just like we know the streets of Stevens Point. They know everything because they've lived it. They've been there. And all of a sudden, this carpenter who has never built a boat, let alone driven one, tells them to go out into a storm. Now, these fishermen, I imagine they had fathers and uncles, grandpas that were also fishermen too. And I don't doubt a few of them perished in such storms on the Sea of Galilee. And now here Jesus is giving them direction to go that way. Now I doubt there was a storm right at that moment, but you know, if you've been on the water a while and you know the area, you can tell when the storm's a-brewing, when you need to motor the boat back to the pier for safety. But they go. Why did they go? Because Jesus told them to. And all heck breaks loose. And it appears that Jesus doesn't even care. He is asleep on a cushion. Sometimes we feel like we've done everything right. You know, as kids, we listened to sister who taught us in parochial school, or we paid attention at CCD. We minded our P's and Q's. We tried to be as nice and as kind and as loving as we could. We've done everything that we've been asked to do. And then bad stuff still happens. We go to the doctor and we get some bad news. Someone we care for tremendously ends up in a car accident. Or even that beautiful relationship of love, that most holy marriage, becomes a relationship of great difficulty and pain. And we can say, why? I've done everything right. I've followed you, Lord, and this is where you brought me. And I think if we're honest with ourselves, anyone who's older than 25 has had at least one moment like that. Why is this happening to me? It's one thing when we do something dumb and stupid and we get the consequences. You know, driving 90 down the interstate, you should not be surprised when the flashing red and blue happens. You don't need a Sherlock Holmes to figure out, why did the police officer pull me over? We had it coming. But sometimes things happen and we just don't know what to do. It's our first reading today. Job. A man who did everything right. And the devil wants to prove to Jesus, wants to prove to God, I should say, oh, he just loves you because you've been good to him. Takes away his property, takes away his possessions, takes away his health, takes away his family. All that's left is the dung heap. And Job continues to praise the Lord. My dear friends, we hit these moments in which we're uncertain what to do, but we forget who is with us in this moment. Jesus. And yes, sometimes we can feel distant even when he's right there. As those disciples came into despair and said, "Lord, you brought us here to perish. Do you not care?" Jesus arises and calms the storm. On this most holy night, as we come together as church and the people of God, may we be mindful that whatever that storm is in our life, there is nothing so tremendous that the love of God cannot bring it peace. And so tonight, as we celebrate this most holy sacrifice of our Lord, as we join together in prayer and bear witness to the miracle of wine and bread becoming the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, as we are transported in time and space to the moment of Calvary in which Jesus gives of himself completely on the cross, out of love for you, may we bring our needs to him, and he will rise up. He will rebuke the storm, and we shall know the peace of Christ. May God bless you always. Rising in faith, we rejoice with our Lord and the love that he shares with us as together we proclaim what we believe. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, life of the world to come. Amen. Rejoicing with our Lord and mindful of how he can calm the savage sea, we have the courage to bring forth our needs to Jesus Christ. that those who are set apart to preach, teach, or minister in the church will witness to Jesus Christ fearlessly and without compromise. We pray to the Lord. That those who govern nations will protect human rights, further the work of justice, and advance the freedom of the suffering and vulnerable. We pray to the Lord. That all people may have an increased reverence and awe for the gift of human life and seek to protect the most vulnerable, especially the unborn. We pray to the Lord. For safety and blessings upon all travelers, especially families during these months of summer vacation, we pray to the Lord. In thanksgiving for our newly ordained Father David Nowicki, we pray to the Lord. For the grace this week to live free from fear and with confidence in Christ's presence, we pray to the Lord. And for the many intentions inscribed in our book of prayer, those held in our prayer baskets, and those we lift to Jesus in the quiet of our heart, we pray to the Lord. And for all of our beloved dead, especially Chuck and Chad Walport, we pray to the Lord. Heavenly Father, we, your beloved children, lift these prayers up to you through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it'll become for us the bread of life. By the mystery of this water and wine, come to share in the divinity of Christ. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it'll become our spiritual drink. Brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, and grant that, cleansed by its action, we may make offering of a heart pleasing to you through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Font of all holiness, make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Thank you. mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Gerard, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Amen.
Behold, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and precious blood of your Son, we ask of your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption through Christ our Lord. Amen. Well, we've got a couple of things happening. Please do keep Father Nowicki in your prayers. Tomorrow is his Mass of Thanksgiving over in Athens, where he grew up, and so I'll be heading out there tomorrow afternoon to join him in his celebration, but let us surround him with love, because, well, not anytime soon, but at some point I'll retire, and hey, he's 12 years younger than me, so hey, who knows where he'll end up. It's hard to believe tomorrow will be my own anniversary as well. It'll be 12 years ago tomorrow. I don't think that's the right way to say that, but you know what I mean. I myself was ordained a priest, so it's a wonderful, wonderful celebrations. Immediately after Mass today, I know it's kind of, well, it's not really hot. It's like 70 degrees in here, but it sure is muggy. But I've got a cure. In the family center, we have an ice cream party all set to go. So grab yourself some wonderful cookies and ice cream right after Mass in the family center. 100% free, just a nice little ice cream social for us. And then lastly, I just got to say, I can't say enough good things about Bishop Battersby. Like, if I wasn't wearing sandals that day, my socks would have literally been blown off. It was just so good. I am so excited to have him as our bishop. I'm so excited for the future of our church. It is awesome. Now, that said, we have that pesky little diocesan annual appeal. You know, we talked about it last fall, and it's due at the end of the month, and we're a little behind. But my God, I'm so excited about our bishop, and that diocesan appeal does so many good things for the diocese. If you haven't made a contribution, please prayerfully consider making that contribution. A nice way for us to come together and show a sign of support, whether it's $5, whether it's $500, whether it's $5,000 or something in between. If we could all just send him a little message of love that, Bishop Battersby, we love you and we support you, that would be such an awesome thing. Like I said, $5, $50, $500, $5,000, whatever it might be, that would be awesome, because by the end of the month, we're supposed to have all that money raised, and we're a little short. Okay, we're a lot short. I'm not going to sugarcoat it. We only have about 60% raised, so we're looking to get that last 40%. If you're able to make that contribution, please do. You can do it online. Instructions are in the bulletin. You can do it with all those lovely envelopes that were mailed to your house, and if you lost them, bring it to church. Just write Diocesan Annual Appeal, Bishop Battersby, something that says diocese on it, and we'll make sure that it gets to be where it needs to go. But gosh, I'm so excited, folks. This is, it's going to be awesome. We are truly blessed. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Go in peace.
Thank you.
Our prayer of thanksgiving. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine.